Howdy folks, welcome to episode 16. Yeah, today we're going to Ningues, so we're heading out to the slice here. And yeah, I'm sure some of you guys were groaning over that lame joke there, you know, with pepperoni pizza and all that stuff. But, you know, think of the bright side, at least it wasn't that really stupid a restroom joke again. Yeah, it's still funny. No, it isn't. Okay, so anyway, yeah, we're gonna head out to, if I can figure out my controls here, we're gonna head out to Ningues, and there are some new updates. As you can see in the corner, the version number has changed, and so we've got some new updates. Let me get Ningues on the target here. All right, okay. And we'll turn this thing on and let's head out. I like how that's docked. Okay. So anyway, what I did was Ningues by default has a big copper deposits and neodymium and promethium. And so what I did is I changed the copper to iron because we're going to need a decent amount of iron and we're not going to need that much copper in comparison. So because I plan to do big builds, and so I figured that would be a decent way to do the resources instead of, you know, having a bunch of copper. And I don't feel bad about it because, you know, I basically chopped out tens of thousands of iron in deposits. So yeah, I don't feel like it's a problem or anything. So anyway, there are some new things, and let me check again. Okay, so what they've got is they added finally a non-enclosed cockpit for the SV and HV. So you can make your own enclosed vehicle that you can walk into and get into the cockpit. And then when you get out of the cockpit, you're still inside the vehicle. And you can make hover bikes. Woohoo! So, you know, the HVs can be made like a hover bike, which is actually pretty cool. And I'll probably make one of those at some point soon, probably to go around this planet or whatever. One of the other things they did was they made some damage models for the equipment. So like the cockpits and the constructors and, you know, cargo boxes, all that stuff is going to be showing damage models so that, you know, the shape of it actually shows like it crumpling and that kind of thing when it takes damage. They also added a door buster and let me see. Let me level out here and check out the map. So they added a door buster. Now this is the type of area I'm looking for. This is actually perfect. This big flat, this big area with all the little lakes and stuff. That's totally where I want to try to build a base. So yeah, that's beautiful. And which way? It's 5 hours to sundown. So if I build over towards this end, I'll have a little bit more time. But yeah, wow, time is cruising on this thing too. Okay, so anyway, that's the door buster. They added that. And so what it is it's an explosive that you attach to the door. And yeah, it's not a Black Friday special, no. It's nice. Oh, that thing's hitting me. Wow, I better get out of here. Okay. It's an attachment that you... It's an explosive that you attach to the door on a POI or a base or whatever, and it explodes and blows up the door. Of course, it also blows up, like, everything else around it and doesn't actually kill armored doors in the process. So it's, for the most part, as ridiculous as the... It's pretty much as ridiculous as the rocket launcher is. So, yeah, that kind of... You know, whatever, but I'm hoping they'll do something about that. You know, they just introduced it, so obviously they have plenty of room to make changes and tweaks and that kind of thing. But anyway, yeah, I think we'll stay out of range of that POI for right now, or maybe we'll go take it out with the ship. I think we'll do that because I actually want to build over there. So I'm going to. Would you stop shooting already, please? You're not hitting it, so stop shooting. Okay. All right. Thank you. So let's sit this ship down here. And we will go take out the P- POI if this thing will stop. Okay. All right, let's see. Let's get up here and let's get in the let's get in this thing. And you know, one of the things I love about Ningues is the low gravity. And let's get rid of this rocket drone so he doesn't blow up the ship. There we go. Okay. And I don't think the POI is going to be close enough to get us. So let's grab these goodies. Not that we actually need them anymore, because we pretty much have a ton of resources, but, you know. So anyway, yeah, let's take out the guns on this POI so we can at least not get the thing shot up. Come on. I think that's one of the guns. Ah, there we go. There we go. And there's a whatchamacallit too. Oh great, we're out of range. We're out of our range, but not out of their range. So, which is fine as long as I can stay out of the range of that red laser thing. Okay, there's that, and there's that, and need to keep going. And come on, there's one. Okay, so those red lasers are the deadly part, so I do need to get that thing out of there. Let's see if I can. There we go. Did I get him? Yeah, I got that one. Okay, we'll get the rocket drone here if we can or not. And that's missing again. There we go. And okay, good, good. We got that guy. And let's get this rocket drone out of here. And there should be a... There it is. Turret right there. There we go. Did we get him? I think we got him. So that should be all the turrets. Oh, there's one right back there, too. With that guy. There we go. He's shooting himself now. Okay. Because they're still doing that where they lead. And let's make sure there's not more of those red ones on this side. Alright. Cool. So, let me raid this. Let me grab this thing here. Let's grab this rocket drone here. We'll loot this guy. Not raid him. Looting is not raiding. Okay, and let's go. I'll show you guys the doorbuster real quick if we can. So let's see. Let's see. I know I've got one in my inventory. I made 5 of them just to check them out. So let's see. So here's what the doorbuster does. Whoa, wrong button. So see, it goes like that, and then. It blows up everything. Well, there you go. Okay, so there's the doorbuster. Yeah, in my opinion, it needs some tweaking. But, So anyway, let's head back here and look at the CV, and I will also show you real quick the damage thingy on the repair and remove tool, or whatever they're calling it now, the multipass, Lulu Dallas multipass, and because he shot me in the side over here. I just had the hubcaps painted too. So yeah, let's see, we'll go here, and we'll just park it on here. Okay, let's park it here, and okay, so let's take this thing, and we'll go out here with the repair and remove, and we'll see if it shows it on here. Oh, it doesn't show it when you're using the drone. Okay. So let's see if it shows it. Now here, what you can see, damage, hit points 27 of 50, so when you repair it, it goes back up. So it will show you how many hit points something has. Cannon turret took some damage. I mean, it's not quite as nice as the SI screen, because what would really be nice would be something like this, where it shows different colors for that. for how much damage there is. And it's I'm used to running and repairing, and it wants to upgrade while I'm doing that, which is not cool. But anyway, okay, so let's get over here and find a spot where we're gonna put our base, and hopefully we can. Is it gonna sit there and shoot? Oh man. They're gonna sit there and shoot. Oh, there's a rocket drone. Okay. Or are they shooting at the POI? I think they are shooting at the POI. Yeah, they are gonna shoot at the POI, so I need to keep moving. Because these things are gonna be stupid. There's the rocket drone. You can shoot at the rocket drone, that's fine. Okay. That's cool. I'm okay with that. Alright, so yeah, over in this area I think is pretty cool. And so we'll sit down. Set down here. And I'm probably going to end up with drone attacks too, because it's a new planet and I'll be setting down a fresh core. Now, I can, if you want to, if you really want to, if you hate the drone attacks and you don't want to feel like you're cheating by turning them off, but you still want to cheat anyway, or if you're playing on a multiplayer server where you don't have access to those controls and you want to turn them off, you don't want to experience the drone attacks, what you can do is you can put your core in a POI first, and that won't register. What you can also do is you can just put down a starter block that you don't care about and just walk away from it. Put it somewhere that, sure, they can attack it, and they can blow it up, and they can attack it all they want, but they won't go after your other, whatchamacallits, your other base, so the second base that you start. But I'm going to do this the legit way, and let's see, did I bring, you know what I didn't bring? That's awesome, all this prep, and I didn't bring my concrete blocks. Okay, guys, I'm going to have to go back and grab my concrete blocks, but let me sit this down first. And I discovered a promethium deposit. So yeah, we're gonna get this thing set down. And there's a drone over there, too. So yeah, there's our new base, and that's where our base is gonna sit. So I am going to head back to Akua? Is that coming at me? I think that rocket drone is coming at me. No. Okay, I'm going to head back to Akua, and I'm going to grab all the concrete blocks and the glass blocks that I made when I was prepping for this episode, and I will meet you guys back here in just a minute. Okay, guys, we're back, and I've got all this stuff here. As you can see, I grabbed all the concrete blocks and some steel, some of the other blocks. I also made a stack of window blocks. So hopefully I should have enough to at least get started here and get the basic layout. My calculations told me that the amount of blocks I'm going to need is about 6,000 for the circumference. It's basically going to be a cylindrical type of thingy. And I'm going to need to get rid of this guy too, because he's going to be in my way. He's going to come after me. There we go. These guys are actually pretty wimpy as far as if you hit him with headshots, you can get him pretty quickly. So hopefully I can do this. Let's get some concrete blocks, and these guys walking around here are making me nervous just because of the sound. Okay. Two, come on, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. Nope, that's not going to give me that. Okay. And we'll get rid of this. I'm going to have to clear out some of this stuff too. And so this is a 12, and from here I'm going to need a, am I hearing a drone? Okay, no. Alright, From here, I'm going to need to go out one, two, and what am I doing? I need an axis here. There we go. And three. There we go. Okay, I can fill that in too. Whoops. Just so it's nice and even here. Come on. What is it doing? Okay. There we go. Alright, and then now we're going to come down by one for two of these. That's awesome. And then we're going to come down by one again. And then we're going to do this. Whoops. Wrong clicky clicky. Okay, and one more. Let's see, we're going to go one. And I'm going to start at this one so I make sure I get it even here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And then we're going to come out 3. And then this is going to come out 2. And this is going to come out another 2. And then it should be 1, 1. Yep. Okay, so that is the basic layout. And I need to do the same thing on the other side. And I can make a circle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And I think I actually went one too far there. Let me see. Get rid of these things, and I can't do that with this. Okay. So yeah, I need to... Wow, is my frame rate dropping? Huh, it felt like it was dropping there. It felt like it was really dropping. It's weird. It's just the way the weapon's moving, apparently. Okay. Not sure what those are, but go away. Alright. So, we're gonna fill this in. There we go. And make sure I get the same on the other side. And that is going to be the basic layout for our base. So let's get this tree out of the way too. There we go. And probably clear out a few of these other ones too while I'm at it. And let's see. I think that'll at least keep them cleared out. Okay, so we're going to, starting here, we're going to go, what did I just do? Okay. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to go 2 more past that, and then we're going to go 2 more past that, and then we're going to go 1 past it, and 1 past that. And we're going to do the same thing here. And this is a 2 like that. And then this is going to be another one. And then this is going to be the edge. So that's going to go all the way across. And I did go an extra block. Okay. So I can remove that. There we go. And I apparently don't have room in my inventory. So I'm going to have to grab that stuff in a minute. Probably because of all this garbage I'm grabbing. But hopefully, must have let go of the control key at the wrong time. Hopefully this will at least keep me safe from the critters. Obviously I'm going to have to worry about drone attacks, but this will keep the critters away. The critters can't run up onto this, onto these blocks. And so at least I'm safe from that. There we go. Get rid of that. And... okay, and what did I pick up that I can get rid of? What is this thing? It's a health, and it takes away stamina and food. Yeah, I don't really need that. So we'll get rid of that. And what was the other thing I picked up? Pixie sticks, I don't need those either. Okay, so let's see, we can get... Not that these are expensive parts or anything. But yeah, okay, so the outside, we're also going to, We're also going to see here. We're going to do this, and we'll get this spun around the right way. There we go. So we're going to smooth this out as well with these. And the regular corners. And more of these. So let's see, this needs to go... There we go, like that and that. And so we'll get this all smoothed out. So I'm going to finish the rest of this up, and I will be right back in a second. Okay, guys, we're back, and it looks like there's a large minigun drone coming at us because my... Whoops, nice. My thing started shooting. The other thing I did is I added in the landing gear because I'm not going to be on a super hostile planet, and so I figure this will be just a little bit easier instead of dealing with... trying to get underneath it and everything. Let's get rid of this guy. Do not want him shooting at my ship. Seriously? Am I that bad of a shot all of a sudden? There we go. And these guys are not nearly aggressive enough or as tough as they should be. Okay, and it's hilarious that they spin around. Okay, all right, so I'm gonna loot this guy here, and let's see. And there's a spider who's not too happy about me being around. Okay, and I don't even have room in my inventory. Yeah, okay, I'll deal with that later, or not at all. But anyway, we've got the basic shape of the base laid out. And that's going to be it for this episode. So we will continue construction and get a lot more done next time because I won't be goofing off with all the other stuff. But yeah, we will get more done on the base in episode 17. So join me then and see what we can get done and how it's going to basically look. We'll see you then. Later.